Hello children, today we shall talk about the industrial society as well as the social change. So my dear children, in my previous videos lectures, I have explained to you in details about the ideologies of the three different groups. Those are such as the liberals, the radicals as well as the conservatives. So these are the three groups who came into being in order to have certain kind of changes in the society, and with certain kind of changes they were trying to implement certain kind of changes in the society, my dear children, and with the changes the society will enjoy a new systems in the society. So dear children, in this industrial society as well as the social changes, as we have understood that it is an era of social transformations and social changes which brings prosperity in the society. So these political trends during the early 19th centuries in Russian society, we see that it is a sign of the new time, and as it is the sign of the new time, it is changing the social systems as well as the economic systems of the society. So dear children, with this system of new changes, we see the cities begin to arise, the industrialist regions developed, the railway network developed in the society, the industrial revolutions happens in the society, and when the industrial revolutions happens in the society, we see the new working class who are coming into arise, who are coming into appear. We see the process of industrialization, it is causing the peoples as well as the men and women to work in industry. So my dear children, this industrial society as well as the process of industrialization, it changes the mindset of the peoples. It developed the society, it developed the community, it developed the nations, it brought several kind of new transformations in the society. So as I have told you that with the development of the new industries, the peoples, they begin to work in industry. The working hours was very long, the wages was very poor, the unemployment crisis was common in the society, the housing problems, the sanitation problems, these are the common problems which was found with the new development in the society. And here the radicals as well as the liberal groups, they were very very upset by seeing such kind of issues in the society, because it is the beginning of the new cities as well as the beginning of the new era, and due to that such kind of common problems are found in the society. So here the liberal groups as well as the radicals groups, they are trying to find out the solutions to all these problems which had been seen in the society in the early 19th centuries. So dear children, as I was telling you about the role of these radicals and liberal, who are very concerned about the social changes in the society. As these liberals and radicals, they were the property owner, they were the employer, and they begin to develop with these industrial revolutions. At the same time, they developed in the society by having trade activities as well as the commercial activities in the society. And they felt that the efforts should be encouraged in the society so that the benefits would be achieved in the economy, and there should be a constructive society, there should be a new society. And why they made the effort to have the growth of this wealth as well as the trade and industries activities? Because they were knowing that with encouraging such kind of activities, there will be the benefits in the society, economic development will happen, and when economic development will happen in the society, there will be healthy citizens. And to make the healthy citizens, many citizens were educated, And during that time, my dear children, we have already discussed in our previous class videos lectures that these revolutionary groups were very very critical towards the aristocracy. Why? Because the aristocracy were the most dominant class in this European country. They were dominating the society. They were enjoying all kind of privileges in the society. They were not paying taxes to the government. In spite of that, they were enjoying all kinds of benefits in the society. And here, the liberals as well as the radical groups, they are very critical towards the privileges of this aristocracy. And they are continuously giving importance in the society that we should give freedom to the poor peoples, and when the poor peoples are given more freedom, then they will enjoy their social rights, they will become a healthy citizens in the society. And why we should give freedom to the poor peoples? When the freedoms are given to them, during that time they will be educated, they will enjoy their social rights, and when they are enjoying the social rights, then those poor peoples would enjoy their social changes in the society. So my dear children, here these liberal as well as the radicals, they believe that we should operate the capital in the society without having restraint, so that everyone will develop in the society. So they are talking about common property. So here the liberals as well as the radicals groups, who are having a different ideology, they are saying that we should invest the capitalism in the society so that everybody should become prosperous, everybody should become developed in the society. And that is the reasons they are continuously encouraging the poor peoples to engage in this industrial revolutions. And many peoples during those times, by the early 19th centuries, many peoples were involving in the revolutions movements. Why? Because they wanted to end the privileges of these, they wanted to stop the privileges of these aristocracy who are dominating the society. They are not paying taxes but enjoying all kind of social rights. So see, that is the reasons in early 19th centuries we see the common peoples were joining hands together, doing these revolutionary movements, and they are bringing sudden changes in the society. In France, in Italy, in Germany, in Russia, we see the role of the revolutionary peoples who are ending the power of the monarchy, and they are trying to build new nations in the society. They are making nation state in the society. We see the role of G.C.P. Magini in 1815. When these conservatives coming into power, the G.C.P. Magini is forming the secret society, spreading his ideology, encouraging the peoples to engage in the process of social change. He is encouraging peoples to oppose the monarchical bonds. He is encouraging peoples to fight against liberty and freedom. So my dear children, in this process of industrial society and social change, we see that when the industrial development happened in the society, when the railway network developed in the society, when the new cities came into being, we see the rising of the new middle classes, we see the rising of the common peoples who are going to work, developing their status, developing their wealth, developing their economy, begin to oppose the privileges of the aristocracy, begin to develop the status in the society. And when they are developing their status in the society, they are continuously encouraging peoples to operate the capitalism without having any kind of restraint, so that everyone will be developed in the society. And they are trying to bring lot of changes in the society. And how they are bringing changes? With the ideology of revolutionary. So my dear children, here all throughout the early 19th centuries, peoples are beginning to have their development in the society, because they are increasing their status, becoming educated, developing their economy, developing their capitalisms. And with that, we see the new industrial societies as well as the social change in Russia. So my dear children, because of these industrial revolutions, because of these railway network expanding, the society is beginning to develop. How? Because employment opportunity is created, people are educated, and with that we see the new era in the society. The industrial society is growing in the society. The social changes are happening in the society. People are enjoying liberty. People are enjoying equality. People are developing in the society. And that is what we see the early liberals as well as the radicals who are continuously fighting in the society to develop the nations as well as the society. Thank you so much for listening to me.